another brand new journey on the Selfie Diary. And as you know, we're all about trying something new and trying something for the first time. So as you can see, we're back on the beach to get some sandy toes and salty hair. And we're gonna try out some really cool things out today as well and go to some of the most interesting places in here. So here's a little clue of where we are today. We're here at the fourth largest city in Sri Lanka. So follow me around and we'll see how it goes. They bring all the fish out to the shore, and out of this net they're gonna put all of this into baskets. And as you can see, they've put the fish into different baskets. These are big ones, and then you get the sprats and all the small fish. And it's something that you see once you head over to Nigambo every morning. It's something very normal for them, so it's all fresh fish. And wonder if everything's actually for Surangani. Keep watching. Of the Selfie Diary. I told you before, we're not too far away from Colombo. We're kind of very close to it. And today we're here in Negombo. Now, Negombo is one of the most happening places in Sri Lanka. And it's the best place to do everything and fun under the sun. So right now we're here at the Jetwing Blue in Negombo. And it's one of the most exquisite hotels you find here right in Negombo. So I'm going to head inside for my breakfast. So follow me around. Of either bee honey or maple syrup or chocolate sauce. So I'm gonna go with chocolate sauce. Yeah. And then some cashews. I might try some syrup too. At Jetwing Blue, for breakfast, there is a wide variety. You can either go for pancakes or waffles, or even you get typical Sri Lankan meals as well, but this is what I like, so.
As you all know, that Jetwing is one of the leading, or is the leading company, is contributing to tourism in Negombo. We have three beach resorts, which is Jetwing Blue, Jetwing Beach, and Jetwing Sea. And also Jetwing Lagoon, which is in between the lagoon and the beach. And we also have a hotel which is purposely built for Ayurveda treatments and Ayurveda guests. So I am really proud to say that, you know, Jetwing is the leading company in Negombo to contribute for the tourism industry. We have a beach, three beach resorts. We have a luxury hotels. The Jetwing Blue, if you take, it has a state-of-art banquet hall, and also blue and beach, and also sea having a wider beach. We also geared to cater to the major functions, handle major functions, the corporate functions, the Indian weddings, and so on. Yeah, as a tourism industry, there's so much of attraction in Negombo. One thing is it's a unique proposition to the international airport. It is the closest resort that we have to the international airport, Katunayake. And within 15 minutes, there are hotels in Negombo. Then also, Negombo is a fishing village. There's so many ways of methods of doing fishing in Negombo area. There's mardel fishing and deep sea fishing, catamaran fishing, then also the fish like crabs and prawns, and it's a very unique feature that we have in Negombo where you cannot see in the other places.
Try something truly Sri Lankan. We're here to try toddy, also known as ra in Sinhalese. So It's gonna happen in this very unique way, and she's gonna be doing all of that. So let's head over and see how this goes. Follow me. Pot, and she's gonna take it, and that's how the toddy comes down, and it's time to taste it now. Kinda sweet though. I must say it's a truly Sri Lankan drink that you cannot find anywhere else. Beach, and it's lunch time, so as you can see, I've got myself a really fancy lunch, and that's an Indonesian style seafood fried rice. It looks really yummy and smells good as well, and also I've got juice, so it's time to eat. Here at the Muthurajvilla Visitor Center. Now this is something exclusively for the guests that come to the Jetwing Hotel chain in Nigamba. And in a couple of minutes we're going to go into a very different environment, and you'll see that. So let's head inside and see what's in store for us. Follow me. We're with Mr. Arun right now, and he's going to tell us about what's going to happen today. Hi, sir.
Yes.
Nice.
Hello.
To meet.
Same to me. So I will give you a little briefing introduction about the boat tour.
Okay.
That we are going to do in a few minutes. So we are going to see this wetland. It is one of a very important wetland in our country. It is called Muthurajvilla and Nigamba Lagoon wetlands. So the red dot here shows this place, and our tour starts in this Dutch canal. You know, when the Dutch were here, they constructed it for transportation, especially spices they grew. They wanted to bring them to the lagoon.
Okay.
Because it was their seaport those days, and then they sent them to Europe. So today we start from here and go along this Dutch canal into the lagoon, and then into this Muthurajvilla sanctuary.
Okay.
And then we come back
to the center.
Yes.
We're going to go into some really exciting, different environments in a couple of minutes, so head over and see what's in store for us. Follow me around. tell me what's special about it.
Yes, actually, this is a very traditional fishing method that the fishermen in southern part of Migambu area is used. So it is called brush pile fishery.
Okay.
What they do is they take those mangrove branches and keep them at a certain place like this, and then they stick around it to stop blowing those twigs away,
mm-hmm.
and keep there about 1 month.
Okay.
So then actually what they have done is they have make a home for fish.
Okay.
So fish come inside and they do not leave this place because they can have a good shelter, and they can feed on little algae and little fish inside.
Mm-hmm.
So after about 1 month they come with a small net.
Okay.
And encircle the space.
Mm-hmm.
And then they bring those twigs and they catch the trapped fish there after about 1 month. So however, those very young generation of fishermen do not like to practice these methods because they don't like to wait 1 month
okay.
to catch a little amount of fish, because there are more modern methods of fishing.
Witnessing a bit of the mangrove ecosystem right now, so tell me what's special about this.
Yes, actually mangroves are very unique and specially adapted plants community to these conditions. Actually here it's very harsh environment, though there is water, it contain high salinity and also heavy sunlight and wind make it very difficult environment for mangroves to grow. So they But they have very perfectly adapted to these conditions here. So these are Rhizopora species, and they are the most primitive mangrove species here. Can see spreading everywhere around the tree is very helpful to survive and grow taller in these muddy environment, and also they can filter salt water here, and they only absorb fresh water in, and also these leaves are very specially adapted to the harsh conditions like the sunlight. The cuticles on the surface of these leaves are very thick, so that it reflects sunlight and it does not waste water, because water is very special here. It's very difficult to find fresh water because of the salinity. Mangroves are very, very important plants and trees for fishing industry, for fishery. Actually, I can say that the fishing industry in the lagoon and also in the sea completely depend upon these mangrove trees, because a lot of fish breed or lay eggs in between these roots, so that you can see big, large fish can't go inside, so therefore eggs and babies are well protected here.
So what have you got to say about the surrounding and the environment over here?
Yes, actually the environment here is very, very beautiful and very nice and very attractive. The mangrove vegetation around this lagoon is very, very unique. There are different types of main Rhizopora and Bugera species. So they provide shelter and food for migratory birds.
So in the migratory season, so there are a lot of birds to be seen.